What's up, chat? YouTube. Today I wanted to talk about, well, first off, I was browsing r/fighters the other day. This post is from a day ago. And I saw something that really connected with me. Someone posted that, is it weird that I enjoy everything about fighting games except actually playing them? And I'll go ahead and read his post. It's not like I don't play fighting games at all. I'll gladly hop into a few matches of Street Fighter V or Unis when I have the chance. But I definitely spend more time learning about the characters, watching, playing story modes, and reading up on fighting game news than I spend actually playing these games or even watching other people play them. Is that weird? It feels weird. There are a few good responses in the comments, but the reason why I even wanted to talk about this was because this is something that I personally experienced for the majority of my life. When I was younger, I actually, like, I'm talking about, like, little, I did play fighting games. I always liked anime games, anime arena fighters, that sort of thing. But traditional 2D fighters always escaped me. I could never just play them properly. But the closest thing I got to that was Super Smash Brothers. I started with Super Smash Brothers 64, and I loved this game. I'm pretty sure I played Samus, and I think I played a couple of other characters. There wasn't that many in this game, right? And I grew up with the Smash Brothers series, so I played all the iterations at some point. And I played them pretty seriously. Not the first one, but the later ones, like Melee, is when I started playing them, like, hardcore, I would say. And the thing about these games is that, first off, they use, you know, the Nintendo 64 controller, GameCube controller. So they had an interesting layout, but using the analog stick was how you played. There was no other way to do it. You played with analog stick. And that's what I grew up playing on, right? Completely used to it, just natural. No issues. So the problem came when I got older that I was just very good at using analog. And so anytime I would try to pick up a fighting game, I would be okay at it, but it never felt as home to me as Smash. So I just decided, you know what, Smash is going to be my game. I don't play other fighting games. This is the game for me. Until Granblue Fantasy Versus came along. Granblue Fantasy Versus came along, and they introduced a character named Jita. Now, Jita is a Shoto, kind of an interesting take on the Shoto character. Nothing really crazy about her, but I loved her design. I loved the anime aesthetic of the game. I thought it was like, wow, like this is a sick game. This is something that I really want to play, something that I really want to be good at. Weeb? Yeah, I'm a weeb. I can't deny it, you know? The anime aesthetic is what brought me in, and it's what made me love the game. What's up, Kaleido? However, I played this, and I know a couple of you guys know this already, but I played this on a normal controller. I played this on a DualShock 4 controller, and I used the analog stick. So in my prime in this game, I made it to A rank, which was pretty decent, I suppose. It means you're a pretty decent player. I always had the mind to be able to play fighting games, but even in Granblue, which is a game that has auto combos, by the way, I suffered greatly from bad execution. My inputs were shit. My inputs were really messy because I used the analog stick. So sometimes I would be blocking and I would think I was blocking a certain way, but the analog move, because it's digital, and it would just mess up, and I would get exposed, blown up. It was actually a meme in my chat that, you know, Taste can't do double quarter circles, or, you know, 236 inputs. And so Jita has specifically a super, and I guess I want to kind of look it up now. Jita has a super where she goes basically Super Saiyan, so Super Skybound mode. It's this one, right? No, it's the other one. Is this all hers? This is, okay. You can just use this. Go ahead and use this. Subscribe. Okay. So, in this game, it's called Boo-Boo. In this game, they had easy inputs, right? They had easy inputs for things. So, this bar up here would allow you to do your specials without actually having to do a hard input. You could just hold a direction and do it. Her super was the same way. There is an easy input version and an actual input version. I believe the easy input version was just one quarter circle, but the actual version was two. I believe that was the difference. So the way it would work is her hair would turn blue when you did the actual input. And when you did the easy input, what is this? Double DCF R1? Is that a double quarter circle forward R1? Was that the hard input or was that the easy one? I know the easy one only required one. Anyway, her hair wouldn't turn blue if you did the easy input and you would do less damage. So people would meme me in my chat that, his Jita can't go Super Saiyan. Or what I did is I used the Jita that had the natural blue hair and people in my chat would call me a cheater. And it was kind of a joke. It was kind of fun. But the core problem was that, and the reason why I couldn't stick with the game was that, aside from poor balance decisions and patches, was that I couldn't do the inputs, and it was incredibly frustrating for me because I was playing against genuinely good people. So instead of thinking about the game like, mind gaming my opponent and everything like that, I was still, after months and months of playing, I was still thinking about my inputs, which is not what you want, right? So I told myself, now this goes back to the post. So I've always loved everything a fighting game has to offer, right? I've always loved the aesthetics, beating up on your opponent, taking the L, holding it, and, learning and growing. It really felt very anime, and I always liked that. And I just couldn't reach that next level. So this is when I found out about arcade sticks. My chat basically was like, you have two options. You can either switch to D-pad, or you can just hold that L and keep playing on analog. And me being someone that needs to be optimal, I couldn't do that. And D-pad just killed the fun for me. Like, it didn't feel right. It didn't feel as engaged as it should have to me. So I was like, okay, well, what are my other options? And then this is when I came across arcade stick. Now, I think the thing about arcade sticks is that it's an investment, right? They're more expensive than a normal controller. This is something that you only do if you really, really want to get into fighting games. And so it's a bit of a jump. And I'm not going to be the guy that tells you have to play on arcade stick. But the point I want to make is that it opened up a whole new world for me. When I decided to take the plunge, I actually got it was called a Mayflash. I guess I should pull that up as well. Mayflash F500 arcade stick. Or fight stick. And this was, $70, so just a little bit over a normal controller, right? And it changed everything for me. The buttons, the slapping the big buttons, the knob, it taught me, and I didn't even realize this was something I was missing out on, was that, and this is maybe something that a lot of people are missing out on, is that inputs should be a part of the fun. It shouldn't be something that you do begrudgingly, like, oh God, I have to do my super here. It should be fun because they're not easy, right? They're not necessarily the easiest thing to do, but it's something that shows like I've put the time in to learn how to do this. And when you get to a certain point, it comes with ease. And I would recommend a fight stick to anybody. I would recommend a fight stick to anybody who is having this problem. Who is like, I love everything about fighting games, but just playing them, I'm not fulfilling that fantasy that I think I should be playing. It's always fun to play with your knob. Exactly. I love playing with my knob. I polish it after every session, and it feels good, right? It just feels good to play on. So I know I've ended up going kind of down a rabbit hole with arcade sticks. And now I wouldn't consider myself a collector, but I enjoy collecting. So I got myself a Quamba, which is what I currently use. I also have a Hori Fighting Edge, which, because of my wrist issues from prior things, I used to play tennis and all that. This stick is not the best for me, but I still love it. And I'm hoping I can get to a point where I can use this stick again. But you don't have to get one as expensive as this out the gate. But you'll find that, at least for me, using an arcade stick increased my fun exponentially with fighting games. It really like made me love them even more, and it made something that I always dreaded, inputs, something that I looked forward to. And yeah, you guys can really hear me whenever I'm playing on the arcade stick, right? And that's a part of the fun of it. It reminds me of like the tactile keyboard thing. Okay. The whole thing is that whenever people are afraid of fight sticks is that, oh my god, now I have to learn how to play on a fight stick, right? I agree. It was not the quickest process, but I decided to learn playing fight stick with Street Fighter V. Now, this is a game that I had tried to play in the past on a normal controller, and I kid you not, I couldn't even make my character move. I couldn't make my character do anything. Coming from anime fighters, the way, it's not chains in Street Fighter, it's called links. And the way combos work in Street Fighter is much more different, very methodical. That's the whole point of the game. It's very, very methodical. I had to pick a waifu, obviously, and I picked the most anime character I could, which was Juri. Now, I would later regret this because Juri is, you know, she is the, they call her the trash waifu trap. You're like, oh my god, this character's so sick. You see people that are good with her doing all this cool shit. And you're like, yes. And whenever you try to play her, whenever you're learning her, you'll find that a lot of characters in the cast have just do it buttons. Just do it. Oh, Tatsu, just do it. DP, just do it, you know. And Juri does not necessarily have that. So you're going to have a lot of people running you down and you're going to be suffering a lot. However, I was starting from ground zero and I understood that. And I was learning on arcade stick, and just playing on arcade stick made the learning process fun. Until I got to a certain point where I was like, I learned enough about the game to understand Street Fighter's not for me. I don't have a problem with getting killed by somebody grabbing their gigantic anime sword, turning the cog on it, the sword is now on fire, they charge at me, and they blow me to bits, right? I don't mind dying to that. What I do mind dying to is having someone literally kick me in the face, not even like a powerful kick, just like feet to face, like 8 times in the corner, and I die. That's not cool to me, right? I found out that, but I was able to get to a point where I knew enough about the game to even learn, and that was farther than I had ever gotten before. It did take me a lot of time to get comfortable, but the process of learning itself was very, very fun and very, very rewarding. And I was still able to stick to my roots of playing with knobs because I've never been a D-pad person. I have big hands as well. So it just doesn't work for me. So I should mention that the whole reason why I wanted to learn this in the first place was because I knew Strive was coming out, and I knew I didn't want to make the same mistake I had been making trying to play fighting games on analog, because everyone and their mother will tell you that's not how you want to go about it. So that brings me to Accent Core. Now, this is probably, aside from Strive, my favorite fighting game, so that just means I'm a Guilty Gear head, right? This game, I played Jam. I played Jam Karateberry. A lot of people find her annoying, but she's a very, very fun character because every character in this game is cool because they're so unique. That was what really drew me to the game, was that even though there's the system mechanics made sense and they weren't super crazy, some of them were crazy, you could pick up the game, they added rollback to this, you could pick up the game and play it and have fun, kind of mash stuff out, but you would still be able to play. You had freedom of movement, the characters were cool, the moves were cool. You know, as Jam, I remember what really drew me, because I tried out so many characters, and I ended up on Jam because I literally felt like I could break the game with my stocks. With my stocks, you know, Guilty Gear is a ground-based footsies game. Most of the fighting takes place on the ground or just above the ground in the air. It's not like Dragon Ball FighterZ where you're literally fighting half the battles in the air. However, Jam had this mechanic called stocks, where she could store cards that were card versions of her moves, and she could use those outside of a normal combo. So you could do combo, go into special, and then you could card, and you could literally have your opponent like dribbling in the air, like bouncing off the walls, top of the corner, and I just thought it was the coolest thing ever. And learning it on arcade stick was the most fun I had ever had in a fighting game, and that was when I had the epiphany, oh wait, people actually have fun doing inputs. Inputs are actually fun for people. And I had never had that connection. So now here we are with Strive, right? Guilty Gear Strive. I play, you know, I made Ramlethal. I eat glue. Elmer's is my favorite flavor. But this is the first fighting game that I've gotten to the level that I'm at, or I've had any sort of, I've been able, this is such a cute picture of her, that I've been able to stick with, right? Because execution was no longer a problem for me. It was never like, oh God, you know, I have to do this or I have to do that. It was like, oh sick, you know, let's do this combo. And you guys will see all the time, I have a great time playing. Winning or losing, I'm having fun because the inputs are fun. The game is fun. The back and forth. I can play the back and forth. I don't have to think about, except for supers, which are, you know, you're supposed to have to think about inputs for supers. I don't have to think about my inputs. I think within like 3 months or so, I felt like I was one with the arcade. Like I had no issues. And I feel like I learned a little bit faster than others. You guys can let me know how fast you learn if you picked up arcade stick. But I still feel like I get better every day. I still feel like I improve every day. And so to the person that says, I enjoy everything about fighting games except actually playing them, maybe it's your proverbial. Maybe you should take the plunge. I actually do have the RAM drip. I'm going to have to show it to you guys one day. And I also got the EX Toe emote, which is also the RAM drip. So, you know, I'm loyal. You know, here at RAM Ranch, we subscribe to the Only Rams. We do it all. We support our girl. We support our girl out here. I recommend taking the plunge. If I could recommend a starter arcade stick, I'd recommend the Mayflash. It's only 70, you know, only, right? But it's just a little bit more than a controller. So if you're looking for a controller, instead of going for like the kind of in-betweens, I would recommend going for a Mayflash. I think it's a great beginner stick. The buttons are nice. I still have it, and it still works great. And, you know, I don't use it anymore. I use the Quamba now. But that's because I realized very quickly, oh, this is how I was always meant to play fighting games. And yeah, I think that's what I would recommend to somebody. You know, you are going to lose. You are going to lose a lot when you're learning. You're going to mess up inputs. But I never had the urge to go back. I was never like, oh my God, just let me go back to my DualShock controller. I never had that thought, you know. And so I can only say that it is extremely worth it. And, you know, fighting sticks, you can customize, you can change out the buttons, you can change out the knobs, you can make it as custom to you as you need to. And I feel like that's something you can't do with a controller unless you spend a ton of money. So that's what I would say. That's my take. That's all I wanted to say today. Because fighting games are amazing. Fighting games are beautiful, honestly. I don't think I've ever been so infatuated by a multiplayer game. The last time I can think about it was League of Legends, but there are so many things in League of Legends that stopped my barrier to fun that were out of my control. And fighting games does not have that. Fighting games, your fun is in your control. If you can have fun learning, the L in learning, you can't spell learn without lose, right? If you can have fun learning something, If you've always felt like you really want to go there with fighting games and there's just that extra little push you need, I'd highly recommend a fight stick. Highly recommend a fight stick. And I would highly recommend giving it one more chance. Because fighting